محمد.
لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل، نعم المولى ونعم النصير. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله الذي لم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك ولم يكن له ولي من الذل وكبره تكبيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه.
ثم الصلاة والسلام والتحية والإكرام على الرسول النبي الأمي الذي أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه سراجا منيرا، سيدنا ومولانا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه.
وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين الغر الميامين المعصومين الذين أذهب الله عنهم الرجس وطهرهم تطهيرا.
اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد وعجل فرجه.
ولعنة الله على أعدائهم أجمعين. أما بعد، فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المبين: بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Please recite the salawat of Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad wa ajjil farajahum.
Firstly, we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the opportunity that we find ourselves here present in this Husayniya, in this masjid, in this blessed place, on this night of the eve of Friday, the Thursday night, where we sat here with our brothers, the mu'mineen, people who have belief in Allah, who have belief in the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, who believe in the Ahlul Bayt. And their belief in Allah is not like the belief of those who've gone astray, but their belief, inshallah, is in light of the teachings of the Ahlul Bayt. The Allah that all of us believe in is the Allah of Ali ibn Abi Talib, is the Allah of Imam al-Husayn, inshallah, when the day of Arafah comes and you recite Dua Arafah, how beautifully Imam al-Husayn alayhi salatu salam speaks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he has a najwa and a munajat and a dua with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he accounts and recounts his relationship and his stature and his status with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I've said this many a time, and I'd like to repeat this, and inshallah, if we were to meet again before the day of Arafah, I'd say this. You have many du'as that have come to us through these sources and the resources from the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam, and then you've heard other du'as as well. People recite many du'as, people pray in different ways. You have different madahib, different sects, different religions. Everyone has a form of prayer, whatever they may call it, however they connect to the Lord High Above. But the difference you notice with the Ahlul Bayt and their du'as and the rest of the populace is the Ahlul Bayt know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without a medium, without anybody introducing them to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is from Allah, by Allah, because of Allah, through Allah. There's no medium, there's no means. And even if there is a barzakh, let's call it Jibreel al-Amin, there's no interpolation, there's no teaching on the part of Jibreel. It's just a messenger to bring the message or to initiate something. Inshallah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the opportunity, we'll speak about who Jibreel is, what purpose does he serve, what is the nature of Jibreel, what is the philosophy of Jibreel. But tonight is not that night. And inshallah, Allah give us the opportunity that we benefit from the teachings of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. Please recite the salawat of Muhammad wa Ali.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad wa ajil
On this blessed night, we recount many things. First of all, those who have passed away, those who have trained us and who have prepped us and who have prepared us. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Allah has given us the tawfiq that after Salat al-Dhuhr or Asr or Maghrib and Isha, when we sit with the mu'mineen and they ask us questions or we inquire, there's a lot we get to learn from each other. And you understand the nature of questions people have, and then you understand the mindset that we operate with and we have to work with. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, this is a big tawfiq that even in a place that is far away from home, most of us, if not all of us, either are ourselves economical migrants, or we're here because our parents were economical migrants. Only a little few are here because they came here to make nashr and intishar of Islam and Iman. But the majority, even the different places, are here because they were looking for better opportunities, better earnings. And in light of the riwayat and the ayat, a man, when he leaves home to look for providence for his family, is like a mujahid who's left and gone towards the battlefront. If he is to die in the path of earning halal risk, he will die no less than a shaheed. So if those people who've left home to come here because it was difficult to make halal at home and they found halal risk, and those of you who are here, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you for the intention that you have of earning halal risk. You are ready to move away from home only so that you may have halal sustenance. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase in your halal sustenance. And I would say, and my father would say, and my elder ulama would say, those people who left home to look for halal sustenance, they may have come far from home, but the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu salam have been very merciful. They brought home to them. And this is something you have to feel. Or if I have permission, sirf ye fikra main Urdu mein kahun, kyunki aksar bacche jo yahan pe students aate hain wo aake ye baat kaha karte hain ki jab tak imam bargah mein nahi aate tab tak ehsaas mohabbat hota hai, jab imam bargah mein aa jate hain alam dekh lete hain,
wah wah
ye sari cheeze bachpan se jo dekh rahe hain, momineen se mulaqat ho jati hai to dil lagna shuru ho jata hai. Ghar wale jab poocha karte hain apne alfaaz mein ki koi janne wala mila, तो ये कहते रिश्तेदार को नहीं मिले, अली वाले मिल गए. मौला आप लोगों को सलामत रखे, आपकी तौफीकात में इजाफा करे, और इंशाल्लाह एज डेज प्रोग्रेस मे दीज गैदरिंग्स इंक्रीज इन क्वांटिटी एंड आल्सो क्वालिटी. मे अल्लाह सुभान व तआला, इट इज थ्रू हिम एंड बाय हिम एंड बिकॉज़ ऑफ हिम that we have the Anwar, and we discuss the Anwar, and we speak about the Anwar, and we make the dhikr of the Anwar. May Allah never take away this blessing from us. And one of the discussions I was having, and we were talking about the elders and how they have tried and strived very hard to ensure that religion comes to us. Sometimes we as youth and young people are, I would call it an ego point or a matter of pride, where we feel we know better than the elder who taught us. When we were young, they would teach us the Quran. The Mawlana in the masjid, the Ustad in the maktab, the Maulvi Sahib in our village, he did the best of his ability to get to us the Quran as he's learned it. His Quran may not be at the level of Abdul Samad Abdul Basit, but to the best of his ability, he is trying to convey and get to us the Quran and the Diniyat. When we grow up, we go back to him and say, Maulana sahab, we've learned this, aap galat padha rahe the. Aapki islah ka shayad itna sawab na mila jitna uski ilqa ka sawab. Whoever with ikhlas has sat you down and taught you, Allah ek Panjatan Panch, Imam Bara, Masum Chauda, has done an ihsan on you. If you have not remembered them throughout the week, tonight is the night, Thursday night. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us this amal of majlis, and may also be a portion of the thawab in this amal. Many times many elders may come to us and they teach us many things. It's because they have learned it a certain way. It may not necessarily be the perfect thing, but to them, this is how they have received it, and with all sincerity, they have transferred it to us. That is why, as a result, most of us sitting here is because of elders have held us by the fingers and by our hand and brought us to the Husainiyah, brought us to the Alam, brought us to the Minbar.
MashaAllah.
To the best of their knowledge and to the best of their ability. Sometimes somebody has a lot of knowledge and no sincerity,
yeah.
And sometimes someone has little knowledge but a world of sincerity.
SubhanAllah.
And that world of sincerity, there's nothing you can match it with.
Yeah.
No amount of knowledge you have can match that little sincerity that comes with that big knowledge, but sometimes you have little knowledge and a lot of sincerity. Allah bless each and every one of our elders.
Yeah.
I would like to speak about tonight, inshallah, Imam al-Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam. As it is the ayyam approaching us soon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran says, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ ذِكْرِ كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. This ayah is repeated twice in the Quran in Surah Nahl, once, and Surah Anbiya, the other place. Both places, the ayah comes in the same version, the same fashion. If you do not know, inquire and ask. If you do not know, inquire and ask. And it is sometimes difficult, sometimes very problematic, that our own ego, our own pride gets in the way of us asking or questioning and inquiring. Allah knows this in my heart. I consider each and every one of you my family and all of you my family members. So if I speak and it may sound, I'll try and use the best words possible, but if it feels that I am not admonishing, al-ayyadu billahi min dhalik, if I am reminding and the tone is a little sakht or a little harsh, please forgive me, because some reminders need to be delivered in a certain fashion, in a certain tone. If they're not delivered in that fashion, then they lose effectiveness. My brothers and my elders, please understand, many a times when we fail to ask and inquire, it is because our ego fools us. We think we know, and at most times, we do not know. Many people who had stood in adversity, who had stood in opposition to the Prophet, they thought they knew what they were talking about when they had no clue what they were talking about. You see and the Prophet sees, but the Prophet will always see beyond what you see.
Yeah.
You envision and the Imam envisions, but the vision of the Imam is infinite, as is the dhat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And your vision is very finite.
Yeah.
Even when we speak to each other, sometimes we feel shame and embarrassment. Better the embarrassment of asking a question today than having to be embarrassed tomorrow because you did not know the answer. Better ask right now. We also in our class when we were young, we'd be quiet and our teacher would put his head down and he'd leave. And he'd very humbly ask, like, is there any question I can help you with? We were more interested in the class to finish and we leave the classroom. This was more of interest. Now we wish, yeah, late, we could go back in time. There's a 100 questions we need to sit down and we need to discuss with him. Why is this the case? Sometimes we feel we know, the other times our ego gets in the way because we do not want to be vulnerable in front of someone who's similar to us or younger than us or like us. Ikhwan, in everything there is aar and there is shame. In the riwayah we have, in all matters of life, in all affairs of life, a man has to hold his dignity and he has to be ashamed and embarrassed when he is devoid of dignity. But there's only one instance in one place. The Ahlul thought, it is when you make talabul ilm. When you're asking a question, there is no big question, small question, right, wrong question. If you feel within yourself a void, I do not know a certain thing, it is wajib upon you to ask according to this ayah of the Quran. When you feel you know, when you feel I'll figure it out, sometimes it's too late to figure it out, especially when it comes to the umur of deen, the wajib and a halal. Sometimes people may be afraid or embarrassed. I'm 50 years old. If I go to the Mawlana right now, But if I go to the ustaz right now, or if I go to my mu'min brother right now, and I ask him, ki bhai wuzu dekhne hamara, am I performing wudu correctly? There's no place for embarrassment here.
Yep.
This brother of Iman, this brother of yours, he's a mu'min brother. Unfortunately, both sides have to be condemned. The one asking because he's embarrassed, and his fear sometimes is very valid. His fear is valid because he lacks the trust that if I was to go and ask him, will my secret stay with him or is it going to become public knowledge? Will my secret stay with him or is it going to become public knowledge? The other night I recited the hadith, I had the opportunity to recite the hadith. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, whoever protects the hijab of a mu'min, Allah will protect his hijab. One thing, myself and yourself, we do it. Sometimes we find out, we hear something about a mu'min brother. Yep. And this is something he does not want it to be public domain knowledge. He wants to keep it, contain it. It is upon us to contain it.
Yeah.
If we want the sattar to make satr of our uyub, the least we can do is to make satr of the uyub of the mu'min.
MashaAllah.
People sometimes are afraid, and this is an example. It may seem funny, but this is a real life example. And I would use this example so that the right effect is derived from it. God forbid one of the mu'mineen has a problem which he has to go to the doctor, and it is something that's very embarrassing.
Yeah.
He will try and avoid and not go to the Shia doctor, he'll go to a different doctor. God forbid people in the masjid find. It has happened. People go to certain someone, and he's afraid.
Yeah.
Afraid that this mu'min doctor, I came to him in privacy, and now he sat down, and now 10 people know about the problem. This is ayb, this is haram, this is not accepted by Allah. The mu'min for the other mu'min should be a shelter, should be a place of solace. If I want to run away from the world, I come to my brother in Iman, and I say, Ya Shi'at Amirul Mu'mineen, support me and help me.
Yes.
This is my secret. Can you hold my secret? If I cannot have this faith in my brother of Iman, then this is a problem. If I cannot go to my brother in Iman and look at him and say, this is something bothering me and troubling me, can you please help me with this?
Subhanallah.
I may not be able to help you right now monetarily or any support that you need, but I promise in Salatul Layl, after Namaz, in Salatul Wajib, when I make dua, when I make tawassul, I promise to pray for you. Aapki baat main apne imam tak pahunchaunga. Isse zyada kuch kar bhi nahi sakte. Hamare haath mein kuch hai. Usko tasalli ho jayegi, usko dilasa ho jayega. Main akela nahi. Main akela is takleef mein nahi hu. Main akela mubtala nahi hu. Mera saath mera bhai maujood hai. Kam se kam wo quwwat mehsoos ho. مولائے متقیان کے چاہنے والوں کے اندر یہ بات نہیں آئے گی تو کہاں ہے؟ خدا ہم سب کو انشاءاللہ. میں یہاں کی بات نہیں کر رہا, لیکن بہرحال there was an extreme case that was brought to my attention. I was informed about it. This case I mentioned, it's very unfortunate this happened in a Shia community, but it has happened. When we are all merciful with each other, when we have time for each other, Azizan Muhtaram, when you people, their mindset is very funny. People don't understand many things, and it is not their fault. It is not their fault. If I was not, if I did not have the exposure to sit with the ulama who have lived with the, misal for the children, like Nitham is here, Hadi is here, these young boys sitting here, for them, if I had a friend who works in a perfume shop, who has a perfumery, and I sit with him for 6 hours, when I go home, what is the scent on me? How do I smell? I smell nice.
Yes.
What if I have a friend who sits at a food store, in a restaurant, in the kitchen, and I'm with him? Even if I'm a vegetarian, I'll smell of burgers all day. क्योंकि उसके पास बैठा था.
जी.
अब जो शख्स 60 साल के साथ नजद में, अपुम में, कहीं पे कुरान और रिवायत के साथ बैठा हुआ है.
हाँ
हाँ हाँ. सही है जी. मिसाल तौर पे. जरूरी है मैं पाकिस्तान के साथ देता हूँ.
जी.
افغانستان کی مثال دے دیتا ہوں, میں افریقہ کی مثال دے دیتا ہوں, لیکن ایک شخص نے اپنا آپ کو مختص کر لیا. Somebody has said, "Of my life is dedicated for Muhammad and Ali Muhammad and Allah Muhammad and Ali Muhammad."
Allah Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad.
Zahre Imam e Zaman Balantar Salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
Someone who's dedicated 50%, 60% of their lives. Some of the teachers, I've had the good fortune of meeting them, 14 hours, 15 hours mutalaya karna unki masla nahi tha. 14 hours, 15 hours mutalaya, aisa nahi ki skim kar rahe ho.
Ji.
In depth mutalaya. Ye jab aapne apne aap ko mukhlis kar liya hai, apne aap ko hawale kar diya aapne Ahle Bayt. One of the ziyarat, and inshallah when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives each one of us to have the ziyarah, tawfeeq for ziyarah. There's many ways to go to the ziyarah, and you ask the imam what you ask for. But one ziyarah, ek ziyarah aise kare, when you go and stand by the bari, and you say, I'm here not to ask for anything. I don't require anything, I'm only here for the love of you, O Aba Abdullah. Na koi zarurat hai, na koi hajat hai, sirf muhabbat. Sirf muhabbat. Ab jab main aapko اپنے آپ کو آپ کے حوالے کر رہا ہوں, آپ جو دستور دیں گے زندگی اس طرح گزرے گی. دیکھیں جب آپ اپنی خواہش لے کے جاتے ہیں تو آپ ابھی بھی ایک فاصلہ رکھتے ہیں من اور ان کے بیچ میں, ایک انا اور انا رہتی ہے. جب آپ اپنے آپ کو بالکل ختم کر کے جاتے ہیں, اب صرف وہی وہ ہوتے ہیں اور آپ نیوٹرل ہوتے ہیں, اور خواہش اور تمنا یہ ہوتی ہے کہ آپ اپنا رنگ ہم پہ چڑھا دیں, تھوڑا سا اس رنگ میں ہمیں ڈھاپتے ہیں. زیارت پر ایسی ہو, خدا ہم سب کو توفیق دے انشاءاللہ زیارت کی. جو لوگ زیارت پر نہیں جا سکتے, اچھا وہ یہاں the boys have arranged for last week also I spoke about it. It's called a raffle, musamihatan, but the intention is that with a small amount, £5, you buy a ticket from the reception over there. And the intention is, if my name comes out, I go for ziyarah. If my name doesn't come out, then somebody else can go for ziyarah, and I'm happy with it.
MashaAllah.
So either I go for ziyarah, or somebody else goes for ziyarah. If you allow, my brothers, I'd like to share a hadith in this regard. Please recite a salawat Muhammad.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
Hisham bin Salim, Hisham bin Salim, one of the companions of Imam Sadiq, speaks to Imam Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam and he says, قُلْتُ فَمَا لِمَنْ يُجَهِزْ إِلَيْهِ وَلَمْ يَخْرُجْ لَعَلَّهُ تُصِيبُهُ لِقَلَّةِ نَصِيبِهِ. This is what of someone. Ab yahan pe ulama, they've put different riwayat together, and they've also, when they translate, it's not only that ek riwayat ka tarjuma nahi hota. بیسیوں روایت کو سامنے رکھ کر کے پھر ایک خلاصہ نکال کے بیان کیا ہے, لیکن یہ روایت ایز اٹ از میں سناؤں گا تاکہ اس کو امام کے الفاظ ہیں, شاید نہ بھی سمجھ میں آئے. بعض دفعہ جو ہے وہ دوائی کی کیا لکھا ہوتا ہے پتہ نہیں ہوتا, لیکن پتہ ہوتا ہے کہ دوائی ہے. امام کے الفاظ سے سمجھ میں نہ آیا کیونکہ لیکن امام کے الفاظ ہیں, شفا ضرور دے. ٹھیک ہے, ہماری بس قسمت یہ کہ لسان حال میری ہے, لیکن کلمات ان کے ہیں تو شاید اس سے فائدہ ہوتا ہے ان شاء اللہ. What of someone who has intended to go for the ziyarah of Imam Hussain alayhi salatu wasalam, but for some reasons he is not able to go, health, time, occupation, whatever reasons, he has the provenance and he has all the things, provisions that he needs to go visit the imam, but for some reason he is not able to, and then he helps someone from his pocket. He provides for someone else. He says, I am not able to go to Karbala. Why don't you go to Karbala on my behalf? Or do your own ziyarat and I will arrange for this. The Imam says, يُعْتِهِ اللَّهُ بِكُلِّ دِرْحَمٍ أَنْفَقَهُ. For every dirham, ایک ہوتا ہے دینار, ایک ہوتا ہے درہم. درہم چھوٹا ہوتا ہے, سلور کا ہوتا ہے, دینار ہوتا ہے گولڈ کا. For every dirham he spends, Allah will give him مَثَلُ أُحُدٍ مِّنَ الْحَسَنَاتِ. For every dirham he spends, he will get the hasanat, he'll get the good deeds. the size of Mount Uhud. For every dirham he spends, Allah will give him the hasanat. Allah will write in his account, speaking in language of the children that understand, for every penny he spends, not on his journey, to provide for somebody else's journey. For every penny he spends, Allah will write the mountain of Uhud in hasanat for every penny he spends. Yes? وَيَخْلِفُ عَلَيْهِ أَذَعَافَ مَا أَنْفَقَهُ. And Allah will return to him multiple times before he dies in this world. Every penny you spend, Allah will return to you multifold. Not in the Akhirah, in this dunya. If you spend a small amount, Allah will not return in the Akhirah. The return, the ajr is there. In this dunya, we'll see an increase in your wealth multiple times. وَيَصْرَفْ عَنْهُ مِنَ الْبَلَاءِ مِمَّا قَدْ نَزَلَ لِيُصِيبَهُ. This is a concept we've learned from the Ahlul Bayt. Like our rizq, the rizq has left the raziq and it's on our way. Our rizq is coming towards Imam Ali alayhi salam. Please recite the salawat.
Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad wa ajil farajahum.
When it comes to this, Imam Ali has a very beautiful narration in Nahjul Balagha. He says, why are you worried about risk? Jitna tum risk tak pahunchne ke liye pareshan ho, isse zyada betabi se tumhara risk tum tak pahunchne ka muntazir hai. Isse samajhne ki baat hai, isko mehsoos kar, main baar dafa main chahta hu bas isi baat par baat khatam ho jaye. Is it the case that everybody who passes away, he has to be unwell for him to pass away? وَعِنْدَ إِذِنْ سَأَلَهُ بَصِيرَ الْإِمَامِ. یہ سوال ہے جو نقطہ توجہ طلب ہے. وَعِنْدَ إِذِنْ سَأَلَ أَبُو بَصِيرَ الْإِمَامِ. Abu Basir asks the Imam عَنْ ذَلِكِ الشَّخْصِ الْمُتَوَفَى. He asks the Imam about Rashid who has passed away in Africa. یہ روایت جو میرے پاس ہے وہ abridged shortened version ہے جو چاہے میں اس کو forward کر سکتا ہوں, لیکن جو longer version ہے اس میں سوال نہیں پوچھنے والے. He asks him like, how was that man, matlab kaisa aadmi tha, pucha ki wo aadmi jo intiqal hua kaisa aadmi tha, acha aadmi tha, bura aadmi tha, kaisa aadmi tha. Sawal ka jawab yahi banta hai ki bahut acha aadmi tha, acche kaam karta tha. Imam ne sawal ka jawab nahi diya, jo sawal ka maqsood tha us maqsad ka jawab diya hai. Imam farmate hain innahu kana min shi'atina wa muhibbina. Khulasa kalam, khulasa zindagi Rashid ki hai ki hamara chahne wala tha, hamara shia tha. نہ کوئی عمل گنوایا, نہ کوئی حال خیر گنوایا, نہ کوئی اس کے اعمال کو کچھ نہیں بتایا. پوچھا کیسا آدمی تھا, ہم یہ بتاتے ہیں کہ اتنی چیریٹیبل آرگنائزیشن تھی, اتنے اس کے شاگرد تھے, اتنے مدرسے تھے. نام نے کچھ بتایا, ہم سے محبت کرتا تھا, ہم اس سے محبت کرتے. بات ہم سے محبت کرتا تھا, ہم ہی یوز ٹو لو اس اینڈ وی یوز ٹو لو ہم. اس سے زیادہ کچھ بتانے کے لیے نہیں ہے, کیونکہ ہم بتائیں گے تم سمجھ نہیں سکتے. اس میں تمہارا قصور نہیں ہے, الفاظ کے اندر گنجائش نہیں ہے کہ ساجد آل محمد حق بیان کرے. الفاظ کے اندر گنجائش نہیں ہے سرکار. مفردات لغت مجبور ہیں, وسعت کے حوالے سے محدود ہیں. علم مجرد جو صادق علی محمد کے قلب میں موجود ہے, الفاظ اس کا بار اٹھا نہیں سکتے. جب انسان الفاظ کا محتاج نہیں رہے گا, جب برزخ کے پردے اس کی آنکھوں کے سامنے سے ہٹ جائیں گے, اب پھر ہر یقین علم یقین ہوگا. جب آپ الفاظ کے محتاج نہیں رہیں گے, تب سمجھ میں آئے گا علی ابن ابی طالب کون تھے. ابھی ہم الفاظ کے محتاج ہیں. لفظ پر معنی ہو, لفظ کے معنی ہم سمجھ سکیں, اس کی عمق تک جائیں, پھر شاید ایک چھلک تصویر مولا کائنات کے اندر آئے.
بشرودی محمد و آل محمد بلند تر صلوات.
قال الامام امام فرماتے ہیں, he says انه كان من شيعتنا, he was راشد was one of the شيعات و محبینا. اتظنوا انه ليس ديا عيون بصيره. Do you think of Rashid, the one who's come from Africa, Rashid's friend? The Imam asked him, like, do you think we have eyes that do not see? انه ليس ديا عيون, we do not have eyes that see. بصيره و اذن و وَآذَانٌ سَمِيعَ مَعْكُمْ. It says, our eyes are with you and our ears are with you. تم جہاں ہوتے ہو نا ہماری نظر تم پہ رہتی ہے. تم جو بات کرتے ہو, ایک خدا اس شاعر کو سلامت رکھے نوح خان جس نے بات پڑھی ہے, بہت خوبصورت بات کی, دل کو لگنے والی بات ہے. کہتے ہیں میری تنہائی میں خاموشی کو پیاری سنتا ہے, میری خاموشی میری تنہائی میں میری خاموشی کو بھی وہ سننے والے ہیں. بعض دفعہ انسان اتنی تکلیف میں ہوتا ہے اس کو سمجھ نہیں آتا کیا کہے, وہ کس طرح سے اپنا حال دل بیان کرے, خاموش ہو جاتا ہے. کہیں اس خاموشی کو سمجھنے والے کو علی دیکھتا ہے. آپ جا کے صرف کھڑے ہو جائیں لوگوں کے پاس, آپ کچھ نہیں کہیں, جو آپ کی خاموشی سمجھنے والے سکتا ہے امام. اب یہ نوح خان کا جذبہ نہیں, یہ روایت میں آپ کے سامنے پیش کر رہا تھا. کیا تمہیں واقعی ایسا لگتا ہے کہ ہماری آنکھیں تمہارے ساتھ نہیں ہیں, ہمارے کان تمہارے پاس نہیں رہتے؟ بے سردن, اگر ایسا سوچتے ہو تو گمراہ ہو تم. اگر تم ایسا سوچتے ہو تم گمراہ ہو. If you feel that I am not seeing you and I am not listening to you, you are misguided. وَاللَّهِ مَا مِن شَيْءٍ مِن أَفْعَالِكُمْ يُخْفِي عَلَيْنَا. تمہارا کوئی ایسا کام نہیں ہے جو ہم سے ڈھکا ہو. There is nothing you do that we do not know. فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّنَا مَعَكُمْ وَعَوِّدُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ عَلَى فِعْلِ الْخَيْرِ. Know that we are with you. Train yourself on being good. ہمارے اپنے الفاظ میں, in our words, the Imam says, know that we are with you and watching you. Behave yourself. Behave yourself. عَلَى فِعْلِ الْخَيْرِ وَكُونُوا مِنْ أَهْلِهِ حَتَّى تَعْرَفُوا بِهِ وَيَصْبَحُوا عَلَامَةً عَلَيْكُمْ وَإِنَّنِي لَآمِرُ أَبْنَائِي وَشِيعَتِي بِهَذَا الْمَنْهَجِ. He says, this is how I train my children and those who come to me. Know that I am with you. One last thing before I finish this. There's a hadith that passed us by today, and I'd like to pull that hadith up. Please recite the salawat Muhammad wa alihi wa sallam. Imam alayhi salatu wasalam says, al-ishtiharu bil-ibadati riba. Al-ishtiharu bil-ibadati riba. Time is limited, I'll go over this quickly. Al-ishtihar, Urdu mein ishtihar kehte hain kisi cheez ka parchar hona. Something is advertised. Anything that is advertised, yahan pe in this context is the same meaning. Al-ishtiharu bil-ibadati riba. When someone is advertised, when someone is advertised for his ibadah, be wary and be cautious and be careful. اگر کسی کا, میں بات کروں بات سمجھانے کے لیے, اگر کسی کی شہرت اس کی عبادت کی وجہ سے ہو تو یہاں پہ شک کا مقام ہے. کوئی آگے آپ سے کہے کہ بڑے پہنچے ہوئے ہیں, چھٹے آسمان تک نہیں پانچ تک تو رسائی ہوگی ماشاء اللہ سے, یہاں آدمی تھوڑا سا احتیاط کرے. وہ جو چیزیں ہمیں آپ کو نہیں دکھائی دیتی ان کو دکھائی دیتی ہیں, یہاں احتیاط کریں. امام نے فرماتے ہیں, الاشتہار بالعبادت ریبا, اس کو نظر آتی ہیں, نظر نہیں آتی اس میں آپ قضاوت نہیں کر سکتے, وی کی ناٹ جج. تو امام کہتے ہیں کہ بی کیئرفل ان دس پوائنٹ. مقصد کیا ہے, مطلب کیا ہے, اینڈ دس از دا پوائنٹ ویئر آئی وانٹڈ ٹو برنگ اٹ اینڈ آئی وانٹڈ ٹو اینڈ اٹ ہیئر. دا پوائنٹ از دس, آج امام باقر باقر العلوم علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام, کسی کا تقرب اس کی عبادت پہ مت دیں, کیونکہ عبادت میں دھوکہ دیا جا سکتا ہے. پھر معیار کیا ہونا چاہیے؟ معیار صرف ایک چیز ہے, وہ ہے علم. علم کو آپ فیک نہیں کر سکتے. نو بٹی, آپ بیٹھ کے تقریر تو کر سکتا ہوں, یو ناٹ فیک علم, کیونکہ سم تھنگ از ایدر پریزنٹ اور ناٹ پریزنٹ, یا ہے یا نہیں ہے. مناقشہ ہو سکتا ہے, مناظرہ ہو سکتا ہے, مظاہرہ ہو سکتا ہے. عبادت میں, اب میں آپ سے کہتا ہوں میں روزہ ہے پورے سب جب بھی میں آپ سے ملا آپ سے کہوں روزہ ہے آپ کیسے چھٹ لیں گے اب تک آپ کر نہیں لیتے تب تک آپ امید مولانا صاحب ماشاء اللہ ظاہر جس سے لگ نہیں رہا لیکن یہ کہہ رہے تھے ان کی بات مان لیتے ہیں لیکن علم ایک ایسی چیز ہے امام علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام فرماتے ہیں یہ تکلم تو عرف یہ منہ کھولے گا پہچانا جائے گا ہر چیز سے کی جا سکتی ہے علم فیک نہیں کیا سکتا علم آپ ریپیٹ کر سکتے ہیں لیکن وہ بھی کنواں ایسا ہے کہ جب پانی ختم ہو گیا کسی اور کی باتیں آپ کب نہ ساتھ سنائیں گے ایک دن اس کو موت ہو جائے گی پھر آپ کے پاس میٹر ختم ہو جائے گا لیکن جو اپنے آپ اکڑ سے متصل کر دیتا ہے جو ممبا سے متصل کر دیتا ہے اس کو یہ پریشانی نہیں ہوتی علم کو معیار اس لیے رکھا کل حضرت عیسیٰ نے نابینا کو بینا کر دیا آج سائنس یہ کام کر دے گی اور یہ دعویٰ کرے گی کہ دیکھو انہوں نے کیا تھا آج ہم کر سکتے ہیں معجزہ کام ہوا مثال کے طور پہ ویسا نہیں ہے یقیناً نہیں ہو سکتا لیکن جو ایسے اعمال ہوتے ہیں اس کو اعجاز کہہ رہے ہیں کرامت کہتے ہیں اس کو چیلنج کیا جا سکتا ہے لیکن ہاں بات جو کہنے والی بات یہ ہے انہوں نے جو کل کہا تھا اس وقت کسی نے نہیں کہا تھا یہ ہے معجزہ انہوں نے جو کل کہا تھا وہ آج بھی صادق ہے اور کل بھی صادق رہے گا یہ ہے علم اہل بیت نے پہچان اپنی ہمیشہ علم کی بنیاد پر رکھی اللہ کے سب سے بڑا تحفہ انسان کو علم کا تحفہ ہے جب انسان علم دوست ہو جائے گا تو اس کو عالم بھی سمجھ میں آئے گا جب اس کو عالم سمجھ میں آ جائے گا پھر باقر العلوم بھی سمجھ میں آ جائے گا جس کو باقر العلوم سمجھ میں نہیں آیا مسئلہ امام کے ساتھ نہیں ہے مسئلہ یہ ہے کہ اس کو علم کی افادیت کا پتہ نہیں ہے اس کو علم کے فائدے کا پتہ نہیں ہے does not know the value of knowledge انشاءاللہ کسی اور وقت کی بات ہوگی لیکن جس کی شہرت اس کی عبادت ہو وہاں شک کے مقام ہے اس لیے when the person was somebody came to Imam Sajjad and said like oh I was a companion of such and such person what a beautiful human being acha what was he doing he was like he was always praying he says yes he says when the caravan was moving he'd be sitting on his right and be praying and when we stop he would be praying so imam said jab sab log kaam kar rahe the to aap caravan mein hai to ab khana bhi banana hai wasail bhi taiyar karne to ye wo sab kya kar rahe the ki namaz padh raha ki is kis kaam ke jab apne bhaiyon ka kaam nahi aa sakta یہ کس کام کے جو اپنے بھائی میں کام نہیں آ سکتا تو امام کہتے ہیں کئی فب ہوا عقلو اس کی عقل کیسی ہے اس سے سوال پوچھا تم نے کوئی اس کا عقیدہ کیا ہے علم کیسا ہے اس کا عبادت سے دھوکہ نہیں کھائیں سوال یہ پوچھیں علم کیسا ہے قبر میں جب لٹایا جاتا ہے اس سے یہ نہیں کہتا اپنی نمازوں کو یاد کرو دیکھو اللہ کو بتانا اتنے روزے رکھے یہ بتانا اتنا کیا پوچھنا رب کون ہے نبی کون ہے امام بتانا حسن بتانا حسین بتانا سجاد بتانا علم کیا ہے کیا لے کر کے آئے ہو یہاں خداوند متعال ہم سب کو توفیق دے کہ ہم بہترین طور پہ جہاں تک ہم سے ممکن ہو اس پہ عمل کریں When it comes to Imam al-Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam and the Masail, it was a difficult time because Banu Umayyah was powerful without opposition. The only opposition they had crushed and crumbled. It was very difficult for Imam Sajjad and Zahiran more so for Imam al-Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam. What we at times may forget, and it may pass us by, when we talk about Aliun al-Asghar in Karbala, when we talk about Qasim in Karbala, when we talk about Aliun al-Akbar in Karbala, when we talk about Aun and Muhammad in Karbala, sometimes it slips our mind, or sometimes we don't remember. You know how old the daughter of Imam Hussein was? Around the same age was Imam al-Baqir. 3 or 4 years old was who? Was Imam al-Baqir alayhi salatu wasalam in Karbala. How do we start and think about? Because every Imam's Imamah started in a time of difficulty. Everyone was very young when they saw the Prophet pass away. Children were young when they saw Imam Ali pass away. But the way Imam Al-Baqir in his childhood has seen the house of the Zahra salamu alayha being trampled in the fields of Karbala, no Imam has witnessed that in his age and his time. At the tender age of 3 or 4 years old, it is Imam al-Baqir who's witnessing the Hujjah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala come into the encampment and call out for his sisters and the ladies, Ya Zainab fi amanillah, Ya Ruqayya fi amanillah, Ya Sukaina fi amanillah, Ya Sajjad fi amanillah, Ya Rabah fi amanillah. There must have come a time where Imam Hussein must have looked at al-Baqir and he says, Ya Baqir fi amanillah, Ya Baqir fi amanillah. Sometimes you forget, in the Bazaar of Sham, we talk about a sajjad, and sometimes in his own house we forget that in those ropes tied with sakina is also the Imam al-Baqir. In the markets of Sham, in the palace of Yazid, in the mosques of the Umayyah, la'anatullahi alayhi ajma'in, where these little children were standing, with them are Imam al-Baqir. So I asked those who were sat here, how would then this man not want to seek vengeance tomorrow? But wallahi, billahi, billahi, when he was given a chance to reign, he says, no, I will respect and honor the path of my grandfather. What was it? I will teach them about Allah, and I'll teach them about the Ma'arif of Al-Bayt. I will educate them. But you know, one of the wasiyat that Imam al-Baqir has made to Imam al-Sadiq, he says, Ya Abu Ja'far, I have with me some wealth which will only last for 6 years. I want you to spend it in Medina. When the Hujjaj come, and the word the Imam uses, this is for Nudba. You know what that means? He says, when the Hujjaj come, is paise ko kharch karna taaki Hussain ki majlis Mina mein kar. Maine Karbala mein dekha hai, Karbala mein kya hua, apne alfaz keh raha hu. Maine dekha hai ki laashe paamal hote hain to kaisa hota hai. Maine dekha hai ki saron ko jab tan se juda kiya jata hai to manzar kaisa hota hai. Nishane hal mein aapke ko maine dekha hai ki jab Ali ki betiyan khayam se bhag bhag kar nikalti मैदान में आती है और नेफों की अनीसों की चादरों को पोंछा देती है, मैं भागकर देख रहा हूँ। देखो मुसलमान इसको ना भूलें, ये मैं पैसे छोड़ के जा रहा हूँ, वसीयत करके जा रहा हूँ कि जब भी मीना में मुसलमान जमाऊ तब तब तुम हुसैन की मजलिस पर पा करना। सयालम الذين ظلموا ايام القلبين قد يكون ان لله وان اليه راجعون حاتم حسين يا حسين يا حسين
Ya Hussein,
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 Ya Hussein.